ஓம் சமஸ்த ஜனகல்யாணே நிரதம் கருணாமயம் நமாமி சின்மயம் தேவம் சத்குரும் பிரம்ம வித்வரம் குருர் பிரம்மா குருர் விஷ்ணு குருர் தேவோ மகேஸ்வர குருர் சாட்சாத் பரம் பிரம்ம தஸ்மை ஸ்ரீ குரவே நம சதாசிவசமாரம்பாம் சங்கராச்சாரிய மத்யமாம் அஸ்மதாச்சாரிய பர்யந்தாம் வந்தே குரு பரம்பராம். So you have come here expecting something. Bhrahma Sutra, second sutra, I think. Second sutra. Expecting more that you must be very immersive in Vedanta. You know this amla? Amla is very sour. You immerse this amla in honey, it will become what do you call honeyed amla? Yeah, we can say English, we can use as you like. Honeyed amla. All sour taste will go. That will become very tasty. The same way. So every year you are coming and you immerse yourself completely Vedanta. You become Sat Chit Ananda. Last year you immersed. I think 80% you become sweet. Now this year you are going to become 100% sweeter. Something happened in your prarabdha. Suddenly Swamiji is not well. Unexpected things are happening one by one. Swamiji Saradhanandaji, he is taking Mundaka Upanishad. Okay, Mandukya Upanishad. Suddenly I also came here. See how karma works. You can see how prarabdha works. I never expected. I came here for 2 days, some other program. I came here. Anyway, I am not going to take any Brahma Sutra or Upanishad. This is very light, okay? Thank you. Very light program. Now, so before going into this, very small thought, because evening satsang, it should not be very heavy. Heavy means what? You have to get sleepy after 10 minutes. 10-15 minutes, very heavy. So this is not heavy, okay? Very light at all. So many points you know already. Now before getting into this topic, I need one person here. One person. So I am not going to give any imposition or homer. By one person. Now I have given him one banana. You eat now. It's here itself you have to eat. Eat it. Okay. Eat it. Ille. I eat it. Just remember this, okay? I will ask you end of the class. Don't feel shy. Oppa, very good, great. Good, thank you very much. And you can go and sit. End of the class will come, okay? Yeah. These two, for whom? I will give this also. End of the class, okay. Shall we go? Okay, now. You like the screen? Ah, you can clap. Yeah, you can clap. So what is the holy book of Hinduism? Who is the founder of Hinduism? This is a very big question. Very big question. This question is asked to our Gurudev, Swami Chinmayanji. The person came and he asked, who is the founder of Hinduism? Gurudev told that. The person asked, Swamiji, who is the founder of Christianity? Gurudev told, very easy. Who is that? Very easy. Jesus. Okay. Then, who is the founder of Islam? Simple answer. Muhammad. Very clear. There is no confusion that. There is no confusion, no complication. Very, very simple. One book, one leader, one way. Okay? Now, the question goes, who is the founder of Hinduism? Gurudev did not answer. This is a sound. Sound I cannot bring in the written form. Just he kept quiet. Now, devotee is asking, what Swamiji, your religion doesn't have the founder? This is a sarcastic question, okay? Your religion doesn't have a founder? This is how he must have asked. Very critical question. You have to say someone, okay? He says Valmiki or Vyasa or Adi Sankara. Who is that? Who is the founder? He has to answer. Gurudev has to answer. There is no one particular founder for Hinduism, as it is not an outcome of one personality's knowledge. This is the answer. Very powerful answer. It's not one personality's knowledge. You getting it? Hinduism is not created by only one personality. Very powerful answer. You have to take this and you have to think over. And let me put the same question to you. Now the questioner get into problem now. But you ask a question, I answered you. Now I ask the question, you answer me. Okay, same question to you now. Who is the founder of chemistry and physics? Are you following? No reaction. Are you okay? I change the space. Listen, I have to sit there. But when I sit, I cannot see this. That's why. Who is the founder of chemistry and physics? Okay? You cannot answer because the science is contribution of so many scientists. Okay? Now, in Hinduism, our rishis were the scientists. Hundreds of rishis, they were the scientists, they only contributed to the Hinduism. So Hinduism is not about that, created by only one teacher or one book. The so many rishis were working and they contributed their thoughts and their knowledge. Now this is Hinduism. Hinduism like chemistry and physics, department of chemistry, department of physics, like that Hinduism. Is it okay? Now, Gurudev, if you ask Christian to give a book on Christianity, he gives you Bible. Simple. Okay, the same way, if you ask a Muslim to give a book on Islam, he gives you Quran. Very simple. Muhammad, Quran. Jesus, Bible. Now, Gurudev says, if you ask me to give a book on Hinduism, welcome to my library. This is the answer. Only our Gurudev can give this kind of answer. Okay? So Gurudev appeared here to give, to convince us very, very logically, scientifically. Wherever we go, we are taking a kunja valuable. Is okay? Okay, va? Right. Wherever we go, we are the torch bearer of this Hinduism, Hindu thoughts. We have to convince people like this only. Not criticizing other religion. We respect. Sanatana Dharma will respect others so that with a large heartedness. We respect. At the same time, we have to glorify our system also. This is Swami Chinmaya. Come to my library. There is no one founder. There is no one book we have. We have plenty. That's why we have a lot of complications and so many questions. Because nobody knows complete Hinduism. When Mahabharata was written, Vedavyasa was telling Lord Vinayaka. And Vedavyasa asked Lord Vinayaka, you have to write this for that Mahabharata with my speed. When I am bringing the sloka, according to my speed, you have to write. So Vinayaka in turn, he told that, excuse me, sir, when I write, according to my speed, you have to tell. Then again, Vedavyasa got into problem. Ayyo, this person is more powerful than me. What to do? One more niyama he created. Okay. Oh, Lord Vinayaka, you have to understand and you have to write it. Okay. So whenever Vedavyasa used to get some more slokas, at that time he will put very, very difficult to go to that. Yanisha sarva bhutanam tasyam jagrati samyami yasyam jagrati bhutani sanisa pashyate muni. 10 minutes to understand this sloka. By the time Vedavyasa collected so many slokas in his mind. You getting it? In Mahabharata, instead of more than 500 slokas, we do not know whether Vyasa understood or Vedavyasa understood or Vinayaka understood or Sukadeva understood. We do not know. More than 500 slokas, nobody knows who understood. Very powerful slokas brought out by Bhagavan Vedavyasa. You getting it? In the same way, even if you take Mahabharata, it's very difficult to understand more than 500 slokas. Then what to talk about whole Hinduism? Who knows? This is like a big, ocean, very vast and very deep, Hinduism. Is it okay? This is our, the system, the book. And hereafter, we should not ask, who is the founder of Hinduism? Tell me only one book. Impossible. This is vast. Everybody, Hinduism accommodates all what the levels of people. Whether it's a scholar or ordinary or layman, everybody has got what that place here. Very big hall we have. Actually, we are not asking question in reverse direction. Now, Gurudev asked here in the reverse question, okay? Now, people are asking, we have one book, one master, one way. Why you are not having one book, one master, one way? They are asking. So, at that time, we kept quiet. We keep quiet. Actually, we have to ask, sir, we have so many books, so many teachers, and so many paths. Why don't you have like me? You're getting it? We never ask this question in reverse. That's our problem. Shall I go to next thought? Are you okay? Now, scriptures are like GPS, okay? It shows that. Why scriptures? Sir, if I like, whatever I feel, whatever my mind says, I can do. Why you are doing like this? My mind said like this, that's why I did. So we cannot take our mind as what the GPS in our life. Whatever I felt, I did it. Whatever I think, I do it. Now we cannot take our own mind or own intellect for our GPS in our life. You agree? Even though you are not agree, you should not agree this. Superficially you can agree. Many people, why you have done like this? My mind said like this. I thought I performed it. No. Our mind, our intellect will perform according to our own Puro Janma Samskaras. The Samskara comes in. Because we have Janma Janmandra Samskara, okay? According to our Samskara, our desire comes, our thought comes. Our Samskara is not what that highest authority for our life. So that's why here our scriptures are coming and taking the what that big role. Scriptures are the very ideal. According to scriptures, you have to bring, we have to change our samskara, we have to change our character, samskara, and all our lifestyle, we have to go along with the scriptures. Wow. How do you know then? How you are telling like this? No, Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, getting it? So we have very nice vehicle. The human body, human mind, human intellect, everything. Equipped very well. Very nice car we have. Nice vehicle given to us. Only it's not working. Engine is not started. Engine is there. It's not started. What started, we are not applying gear there. As you had very nice vehicle. Very costly vehicle has been given to us. Manushya Janma. Jantu naam nara janma durlabham. Atha pumstvam tato viparada tasmad vaidika dharma marga parata. All qualifications complete. Why you don't start your car? Waiting for Chandra Garhana. Yesterday only Surya Garhana has come. Chandra Garhana. Hey, start your car. You want to start your car. So we are blessed with that. Durlabham thrayame vaitate. Devanagrahetu. Manushyattvam. Mahapurusha, everything we have, but still, okay, so we have very good vehicle, but we need to have GPS there. Where to go? I am ready, sir. I started a car. I am ready. Where to go? Go somewhere. Sir, goal should be there. Path should be clear. Goal should be there. On the path, what are the problems you may get in your life? That also you have to be very, very clear. You're getting simple, you cannot go that ride on the car. Very tough for that path will be. So you have to ride your car and you have to reach. GPS there. What is that GPS? You like this bird? Oh, in between, because you're sleeping, no? Where should I go? Where am I? First we have to where I am and where we have to go. For that we need to have GPS. That GPS, our scripture, okay? Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita. Yet Sastra Vidimusruja Vartate Kama Karataha. According to our desire, according to our thought, we cannot live in this world. Krishna is very, very clear. Yes, Sastra Vidim Utsruj. Having given up scripture, if you do according to your own desire and your own idea, you will land somewhere else. Therefore, Arjuna, you be careful, don't go with other people. You are my disciple. I tell you one thing. So even you should not listen to my words. So Krishna says, Tasma Sastram Pramanam De Karyakari Vavastita. Therefore, you have to take scripture as a final authority. Scripture will show you the nice path like GPS, and it will show where you are, where you have to go, what are the problems you will have on the path, and how you have to overcome, how you have to reach. Therefore, the scriptures. Is it okay? Okay only. The holy book of Hinduism. Now, we have so much of books, né? So many books we have. We have Ramayana, Mahabharata, 18 Purana, scriptures of the Smritis, and Prasthanathraya, Brahma Sutra, so many commentaries on Brahma Sutra, Bhagavad Gita, so many hundreds of the commentary on Bhagavad Gita, Upanishad, 108, luckily we have only 10, more than enough. If you don't have time to read even 10 also, so much. Even if you take Ramayana, more than 80 Ramayanas, luckily all the Ramayana, Rama is a hero. They are not saying the hero there. Oh, more than 80. Heroine is Sita only. So many Ramayanas. We don't have time to read. We don't have time. So many things in our system. Therefore, when some other people from other religion, when they ask questions, we do not know. Why? We study very little. So many things are lying down. We don't have time also. When you read something, you read what the Mahabharata, you take Mahabharata, you read Adipura. By the time you reach what the Mahaprasthanika Purva, you have forgotten Adi Parva. What is the content of Adi Parva? You are getting 1 lakh sloka. 4 times before that, like Ramayana. Ramayana only 24,000 slokas. Mahabharata, 1 lakh. In between, when you read this about the Mahabharata, already you forgotten your family problem. You totally forgot this for that. Getting it? This is Hinduism. That's why people are asking from outside questions. It's very difficult for us to answer. Very difficult. Why? Content is so much. What to remember? What to forget? Contextual also. So they ask question according to this context you are explaining. According to this context it's contradicting. Now you do this anvaya. Samanvaya. You just got that. Make it very right. It's difficult for us. Okay? So we have supermarket, sir. We are not having only small shop. Hinduism is like supermarket. It's not small pan shop. Are you getting it? In pan shop only they are selling pan. Supermarket, you do not know what we have. Not supermarket. So many supermarkets together is mall. You getting it? Who is the owner of mall? What is the department there? Electrical department, electronic department. So, you're getting it. Sometimes you enter the mall, you forget in which direction I entered. Where is my car? You're getting it? So many times it happens. Why? It's very, very big. Hinduism is very big. You're getting it? It's not pawn shop. In pawn shop, only one rack is there. You know, pawn number one, pawn number two, pawn number three, that's all. Morning 9 o'clock, you open the door. 11 o'clock, it gets over. Yeah, it's mall, sir. Everybody can enter. And whatever the object you want, you can get it. You getting it? Sarvebhya papa krittamaha. Even if you are the doctorate in papa, you getting it? You have a place in this hall. Realize Hinduism, Sanatana Dharma. Okay, we have so much of scriptures. But all the scriptures has got the root is our the original scripture, the root is Vedas. Okay? From the Veda only, all the scriptures are written by our great rishis. Vedas are the Moola Grantha. Vedas. Okay, now this is Vedic Rishi. This is Vedic Rishi, okay? This is Vedic Rishi. Like this, hundreds of rishis lived in India, Bharat. Hundreds of rishis in Himalayas. In the deep meditation, they got this Vedic mantras. They are not the creator of the mantra, they are the... they are the drashta, mantra drashtas, not mantra karta. You know very well that. So they become like radio. You see this radio? Very old radio. Old means 10 years back we used. Old means not 100 years or 200, 10 years. Nowadays old means what? Just 2 days back. Yeah, we are living in the modern world. So every day we are updating new apps. In those days means just 10 years back. 10 years back, we were using this radio. Now it's outdated. You cannot get this radio on the market. Just you go and get it. Sir, do you have radio? They will look at you top to bottom.
Where are you coming from? Some forest? Look. Radio in those days, we used to have radio. The radio has got this knob. Okay. If you tune the radio, you will get this music or song. Is it okay? The same as the rishis, they considered their, what is that, system, the human system as the radio. They tuned themselves very nicely and they could hear this Vedic mantras. And they received the Vedic mantra and passed this Vedic mantra to their shishyas. Their shishyas also, or the, they also climbed up to this rishi state and they also received the Vedic mantra. Already they received Vedic mantra from their gurus. And these people also, they found the Vedic mantra. Like this, they collected the Veda mantras and they passed on. This is how it came. This is called Guru Parampara. Without any notes, without any what that iPad, nothing is this. Simply they heard and they passed on. This is why this is called Sruti. Hundreds of rishis, thousands of rishis, they lived and they passed. This is their lifetime job. Living in meditation and received this Vedic mantra and passed. After some time, Bhagavan Vedavyasa understood, oh, this is not going to work hereafter. Hereafter, this will not going to work. Why? In Kali Yuga, because the end of the Dwapara Yuga, Lord, what that, Vedavyasa, he appeared. He took avatar, end of the Dwapara Yuga. He found that, oh, in Kali Yuga, people will not work like this. They need to have some notes, book, printed book. Otherwise, they may miss this Vedic mantra. He understood our mind, what that nature. Bhagavan Veda, asya nisyos, asya mahato bodhasya niswasita medat, rigveda, yajurveda, samaveda, like this, the mantra goes. The Vedic mantras are like, you like this child? Where? When you say the child takes birth, when child takes birth, that day itself the child gets this breath. You agree? When it takes birth, the same day it takes this breath. When the jiva comes, the birth comes. When you say this, the day it takes birth or day it gets the jiva, it takes this breath. In the same way, when the Lord, the birthless Lord, for the birthless Lord, the Vedas are like what that? Niswasitam, for the breath. The Lord is birthless, the Niswasitam also birthless. Have you got that idea? Suppose you say Lord took birth 4,000 years back, simply for a simple logic. The Brahman took birth 4,000 years back. Simply for joke sake only, okay? Because our Upanishad Brahman is ajaha, birthless. Suppose taking birth. When 4,000 years back the Brahman takes birth, at that time, the Vedas also came with Brahman. You getting it? Suppose Brahman is birthless, then Vedas also birthless. You got it? Say yes. Vedas, Brahman is birthless. For the Brahman, the Vedas are like breath. That when you say Brahman is birthless, Vedas also birthless. Simple logic. Therefore, this, what that? The Vedic culture is called Sanatana Dharma. You getting it? The Vedas are Sanatana, like Brahman. So this whole Hinduism is based on Vedas. This is called Vaidika Dharma because Veda. This is eternal Sanatana Dharma. Now, in the modern days, the British came and they gave the name Hinduism. The Hinduism is very modern name. But our original name is Sanatana Dharma, the Vaidika Dharma. Why? Based on Vedas. Based on eternal Vedas, this, what that system is formed. Okay? Our Bhagavan Vedavyasa, he collected all the Vedic mantras and edited. Excuse me, he's not written, he's edited, okay? I tell you, simply you are going to publish a paper, one paper, or one book you are going to write. You just collect the material from all the people and you edit, you will die. Why? Content is like that only. Because you are going to publish a book. Once in a month you are doing what that, some spiritual magazine. You collect material from other people, then you are going to edit. Ayoyo. So whatever the hair I have little, that also I lose. Very difficult. You have to read and you have to edit and you have to put in the correct line order. Are you getting it? Those who are edited, they can understand what is the work of editing. Bhagavan Vedavyasa collected all the mantras from the rishis and edited. To edit this kind of work, Lord should take birth. Vyasaya
Vishnu, the ordinary person cannot do. It is not intellectual work. The Lord himself should come and he has to edit. Bhagavan Vedavisa edited and kept the name Rig Yaju Sama Atharvayana, and he has given the script for, and he called four rishis, four students, and he has given. Now you do prachara and work on this. You getting it? You pass on this knowledge to a next generation. He only collected and edited. Not created, not composed, this is compiled and edited. We should be very, very clear. Before Bhagavan Vedavyasa, so many rishis for that brought out this Vedic mantra. So we cannot say Vedavyasa created or the founder of Hinduism. No. He just worked for Hinduism. Is it okay? Why he credited? Because he understood. Now I'll tell you, you don't remember even your phone number also. You will agree with me. So somebody has to tell me your phone number once, 1 minute. Can you tell my phone number?
Why? Manda. So manda mataya. Manda bhagya. Bhagavad Gita says that. We will become so manda buddhi in Kali Yuga.
Very clear. Ask your phone number. I do not know now. In those days, we used to remember so many names because phone are getting it. In those days means just 5-10 years back.
Because we used to ring like this. We remember so many names. Now suppose we are going some flight or some helicopter, some accident.
But luckily our karma is so good. So we fall into some island somewhere else. All cell phone is gone. Cell phone means our prana. Our prana is gone.
Nowadays, prana... For the Vedantic people, prana is inside. For ordinary people, prana is in the cell phone. If cell phone goes, prana goes.
We lost our cell phone, everything, all our... Suppose in the island, the people are asking, what is your... Tell me your contact number. Da, 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 da.
We will not tell our own friend's number also. Are you married?
Yes.
Tell me your wife number.
It's very deep. Are you getting it? Manda buddhi. We become so manda buddhi. In those days, we used to, you take the pencil and we used to have this blade, no? The razor blade used. Now mission has come, the mission. Tar, 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 tar. Now mission, okay? The sharpener. Now you give one blade, razor blade, and you give one pencil, finished. You have to go to hospital. We lost that ability to do it. Are you getting it? Now, still more the development has made. Now, those days, 5 years or 10 years back, we used to get the sharpener and just now, no need to hold the sharpener. So, one machine has come. Just you have to keep. Finish. Getting it? Manda buddhi. All our skill has gone, all our ability has gone now. Science has developed so much. Bhagavan Vedavyasa knew this 4,000 years back. He edited, compiled. You getting it? For us, this is how he brought Veda. He protected Vedic ideas. Okay? This is Veda. Now, our Gurudev, Swami Chinmayanji. So, what he says about this Veda? Vedas. No, Bhagavan Veda, we have edited. Veda means people, we are telling that Vedas are indestructible. It's a Sanatana, this and that. Suppose you go and tell like this. Vedas are indestructible. It's a Sanatana. The people will take one Vedic book and they will burn it. Getting it? Vedic book, they're like, hey, your Vedas, I burned your Vedic book just now. Now, we should not understand the indestructible of the Vedic, or the idea means what? Vedas are eternal means what? Our Gurudev brings the idea. When the Hindus believe that the Vedas are eternal, they do not mean their Palmyra books are indestructible, or they do feel, do they feel that their Bhojapatras are imperishable? You're getting it? It's not Palmyra tree. We have so much in our library. So easily people can come and burn. So many were that those days Muslim invaders, how they burnt our libraries. They may burn our libraries, but knowledge is indestructible. You're getting it? The knowledge. So Gurudev says that the Vedas are indestructible means not the Bhojapatra or Palmyra trees. Their ideas in that the Bhojapatra is very eternal. This is what they meant. The holy sounds are very eternal. You getting it?
When they say the Vedas are eternal, they mean only that the knowledge, which is the theme of the Vedic literature, is eternal. Only the Vedic ideas can bring this kind of, what, that message. Getting it? Yeah, you're getting it. That's why this is called Sanatana Dharma, Vaidika Dharma, or Hinduism. The modern name is Hinduism. Are you getting it? In those days, there is no religion. There was no such other religion, the foreign religions. Just for the 2000 years back, no religion came inside. When British came, one religion came. Now other people inverted, other religion came. Before that, there's no religion. So Sanatana Dharma, the lifestyle of people, those who are living in this Bharat Bhumi. Okay? So when you say this is called Sanatana Dharma, because based on Veda, the eternal Veda. This is called Vaidika Dharma, based on Vedas. No, the modern name is Hinduism. Is it okay? What is the content of the Vedas? Okay, we understood what is Veda. So what is the content? What is there in there? You like this orange? Say yes. You like the orange. This orange. This orange can be split into two pieces or three, four, five, according to our comfort. Okay. Suppose you have three people, including yourself. You can split into three. You agree? Suppose four. You can. Suppose two. Suppose one. You are very happy. No need to split. Swallow it. So when this kind of fruit has got this facility to split according to our need. The same way all the four Vedas, we can split according to our need. Our need means according to our context, according to our study, we can split. Now, Vedas can be split into four, three, or two. You understood. Now, this Vedas, now we are going to split into four sections. Of every Veda has got four sections, okay? Mantra, Brahmana, Aranyaka, and Upanishad. Four part. The first section is called Mantra. Okay, the first section, this Mantra, contains mainly expression of the wonderment, joy and ecstasy at the choking vision of the beauty in nature's exuberance. That means what that? The praise, stuti of the Lord by seeing this nature's beauty, mantra. Mantra has got only the stuti aspect. Okay. All this is Gurudev words from Upanishad, okay? This is not mine. Excuse me. All our Gurudev words from Upanishad only collected. And next, second portion is ritualistic performance. Brahman. All rituals. How you do rituals, where you do, what you have to do, all the, what is that, the content. It has got ritualistic performance. The third one is Aranyaka. Aranyaka third is meditation. Upasana. It explains about Upasana. You have to go to forest. In those days, they went to forest. You can know where is the forest. The home itself is forest. More than that, I am not telling you understood. Okay. Make good forest. Why? Already I am there, sir. Okay. Vanaprastha. Okay. You go to forest and do meditation, upasana. And finally, you have to come to Upanishad, last section, okay? It has got spiritual knowledge. Now, we are not focusing on mantra. There's no Brahmana, no Aranyaka. Straight to Upanishad. We are sitting here. Straightly we are coming and sitting in Upanishad class. That to Mandukya. For great sadhaka Mandukya, this 12 mantras is more than enough. You study Mandukya. Ha, uha, uha, uha. Ahamannam, ahamannam, ahamannam. What happened? Realized. Tell me. I do not know how to tell. Ha, ooha. Ooha, oo. Experience. Only one Upanishad more than enough. Bhagavan Ramakrishna Paramahansa says that to commit suicide, to kill ourselves, we need to have only one, what that? Needle is enough. One needle is enough to kill ourselves. But to fight with other people only, we need to have so many weapons. To realize only one Upanishad. To give lecture, quote here and there. This, he says like that. He says, what you say, whatever they say, that only I said. To realize for the nice student, nice sadhu, one Upanishad, Mandukya. Now, we have come into the fourth section, Mandukya, the Upanishad. Okay? Now, again, the Vedas are, now, Vedas we split into four in the earlier slide. Now, you can split into four. Three, karma, upasana, and jnana. So, mantra, brahmana, and the three section is covered in karma and upasana. The upasana, you can see that vanaprastha, are getting at the aranyas upasana. Mantra and brahmana put together is karma. Karma, upasana, and jnana ganda. Okay, Upanishad is jnana. Okay, so again you can shrink into two, karma and jnana. Karma has got what that? Mantra, brahmana, aranyaka put together karma. You're getting it, the orange fruit is very nice example, very nice. You can split according. Now, karma, brahmana, mantra, brahmana, aranyaka, karma ganda. Now, jnana ganda is Upanishad. Okay? This, another other name of jnana ganda is Vedanta. Why? It's the essence of Vedas. Anta. Vedas anta. Therefore, Vedanta. Whether it's jnana ganda or Vedanta, one more name for this Vedanta, Upanishad. You got it, I know. So we can tell this jnana ganda of Veda or Vedanta or Upanishad. All these three names are identifying only one thing. Okay. You understood. Okay. Now, Upanishad. Upanishad is very Upanishad. You are very, very familiar. Very, very simple, very familiar. Okay. Not need to give much explanation. Now this Upanishad, according to Kathopanishad, Kathopanishad introduction, Bhagavan Adi Sankaracharya writes this, what is that? Commentary for the Upanishad. He is not giving his own interpretation. You would understand. Sometimes you write some sloka, you give your own interpretation. Whose interpretation this? Mine. Who wrote the sloka? Me only. Oh, your own sloka, your own interpretation. You can give. Now here Bhagavan Adi Sankaracharya, he takes that Upanishad. He is not giving interpretation. He gives the meaning according to the grammar. Very interesting, very interesting. According to grammar, upa and ni, okay, two upasargas. Upa and ni, two upasargas united with the shat. Okay? And sat has got one more pratyaya. According to this pratyaya, the shat has got, getting the meaning of the sat. He gives the meaning for the sat. According to grammar, sate dadoho visharana gati avasadana artasya. This sat has got meaning, visharana. Visharana means destroying. Gati means leading and avasadana means weakening. What is destroying, what is leading, what is weakening here? Destroying our ignorance. Upanishad, that which destroys our ignorance. Gati, the Upanishad that takes the jiva towards the goal of Brahman. Gati. And one more, loosening our bondages, getting visharan, loosening our bondages, avasadana. Loosening our bondages, taking us towards the goal, and it destroys the ignorance. In all the way, the meaning is already there in the sat. You see, he is not giving interpretation. According to grammar itself, it has got meaning. Very, very powerful thought. That's why Bhagavan Adi Sankaracharya's word, the top of the acharyas. Such a great jnana yogi. Not the interpretation. You're getting it? Upanishad. Now see, this is the original commentary of Kathopanishad. You go to Kathopanishad, you take before the introduction part, he has given this comment. Yeah, this is the main. Avidya he samsara bijasya visharanati himsanati vinashanati ityanen arthayogena vidya upanishad iti ucchate. You can use his words only. You can find in Kathopanishad. Okay, destroying. Meaning, second meaning. Purvokta visheshanati mumukshunva param brahma gamayati. It takes all the mumukshas towards that goal. That's why it is called Upanishad. Okay. And the third meaning. Garbhavasa janma jaradi upadrava vrindasya lokantare paunam punyena pravrutasya
avasadayitrutvena shaitilya apadanena. Shaitilya means loosening. That's why it's called Upanishad. In three ways, dasade dadoho. Getting it? This is the meaning of Upanishad. It's okay, sir. Again, we are coming back, concluding this. Okay? Upanishad means gati avisharana gati avasadana. Is this too much for you? Even though this is too much, you cannot escape. You have to listen. Why? Doors are locked. Screen also put. Sometimes you cannot do anything. There is way to look at watch.
I have seen all the people so many places. Like.
Simply taking a note. Very good.
Very nice. Sometimes you watch from here, you laugh, you have to control your laughter, then you have to continue.
Okay, little more time, okay?
Continue.
From the Rig Veda, we have taken Aitreya Upanishad. The Mahamantra, this Mahavakya is there in the Aitreya Upanishad, Prajnana Brahma. From the Yajurveda, we have taken four great Upanishad, major Upanishad, okay? Isha, Katha, Taittiriya, Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. Aham Brahmasmi belongs to Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, Mahavakya. Okay, from Samaveda, Keno Upanishad and Chandogya Upanishad, Mahaveda of Tattvamasi belongs to Chandogya Upanishad. From Atharana Veda, Prashna, Mundaka, Mandukya. Where, what you are studying? Mandukya from Atharana Veda. In this Mandukya, we will get one Mahamantra. Ayam Atma, Brahma. Okay, all these 10 Upanishads are major Upanishads, okay? Major Upanishad, it has got the complete theme of our life. That's why this is called major Upanishads, 10 Upanishads. Okay, 10 Upanishads. Now, these Upanishads are under the section of Prasthanathrayas. Now, we are introducing one more point. Prasthanathrayas, we have got three philosophical books in Hinduism. The first Upanishad, Bhrahma Sutras and Bhagavad Gita. Now, you have come for Bhrahma Sutra, but you are studying Upanishad.
We thought we have come here to study Bhrahma Sutra.
Actually, yesterday itself I should have gone, but anyway I have come. I gave 1 week leave. Anyway, I am away from my family. In a way, I am very happy. I want to get peace here. That's why I came here. That's Brahma Sutra or Upanishad. Even if you conduct 1 week meditation, I am okay. Different mindset. I have come for Brahma Sutra, sir, here. But you are conducting Upanishad. Thus, all these belongs to what that? Belong to Prasthanathraya. Three basic what that? The foundation of Hinduism. Gurudev says these three pillars of Hinduism. Upanishads are declarations of rishis, okay? The pure mantras we are learning. The end part of Vedas. These Upanishads are converted. All the Upanishad revelations, okay? All the ideas are scattered. Bhagavan Vedavyasa collected this idea and he put very nicely in the book. That book is called Brahma Sutra. 555 sutras according to Advaita concept. If you go to Dvaita and Visishtadvaita, they add few sutras, split few sutras, they have different number. But according to Advaita philosophy, we have 555 sutras. The thread, in this thread, he just made very nice mala. Because now see, in the garden you find so many flowers, very different flowers, garden. Bhagavan Vedavyasa brought all the flowers and he made very nice mala according to this color. Very nice mala. This section should be there. He brought all the Upanishad idea and brought here and he gave very nice logic also. That's why this is called Nyaya Prasthana. Upanishad or Sruti Prasthana. Heard and what that revealed. This Nyaya Prasthana. Bhagavad Gita Smriti Prasthana. Bhagavan Lord Krishna studied all the Upanishad from Sandipana Rishi. And he reflected and he brought same idea to our Arjuna. Because Arjuna, if he conduct Brahma Sutra for class for Arjuna, Arjuna would have died there itself on the spot. On the spot. Tongue.
suffering, sir. You are conducting Brahma Sutra class. Athato Brahma Jignyasa, top. Died. Getting it. Already suffering there. Upanishad also will not work there. It's not worth that student with Viveka, Vairagya, Samadhi, Sambhati, Mumukshutva, no peace of mind. All disturbed mind. Are you getting it? Gandhi Vamsaram Sade Asta, Tokchaiva Paridakhyate, Nachachaknomi Avastatam Brahmitiva Chamemanaha. Isn't morning 6 o'clock Upanishad class is going on? You take bath, you go to Bhagavan Adishankara, you do Namaskar, you come and sit. Peacefully we are sitting here. No family problem. Why? Not married. No worries. How can I bring up my children? No worries. If you are not married, 80% you cross the samsara. Only 20% read Upanishad, you can cross quick. You will not come back. You are peacefully sitting and studying all the Upanishads. Arjuna wanted to get away from the problem, but Krishna only says, compelled, you have to do it. You have to do it. You cannot go. Sir, I will go to restroom. Can I come back? No. You cannot go. 3 hours. You chant Bhagavad Gita from the first chapter. Dharma Kshetra, Kurukshetra, you find my Matir Mamma. Okay? Just to chant this whole slogan. 3 hours it will take. No restroom. Sit down. Tea break, no break. I will break. Sit down. He sang. That's what Gita. Bhagavan sang this Upanishad idea. Bhagavad Gita. You getting it? All the three things are the same ideas for that. Put into different way of for that presentation. You want to see this presentation, way of presentation? I'll tell. The theme is Jiva, Ishvara, Jagat, Bandha, Moksha and Sadhana. All the themes are discussed in Brahma Sutra also, in Upanishad also, in Bhagavad Gita also. So no need to worry. I have come here. Something is going anyway. Next year, I decided. Next year, first you book, don't confirm. Our mind will work like that only. Are you coming next year? We will see. I do not know whether God's grace is working or my karma is working. Now you keep coming. Getting it? All the three Prasthanathrayas talking about this matter only. Different word that presentation. The subject matter is same. Okay? Now, Bhagavan, what that? Madhvacharya, Ramanujacharya, and Adi Sankaracharya. Getting it? These three great acharyas have written commentaries for Prasthanathraya. All the great acharyas. First Bhagavan Adi Sankaracharya came in 8th century. And after that Adi Sankaracharya, Ramanujacharya came in 11th and 13th century Madhvacharya came. Great acharyas, they have written commentaries. All Brahma Sutra, Bhagavad Gita and Upanishad. People are fighting among them. The followers are fighting. Are getting it? The followers of Dvaita will fight with the followers of Advaita. Advaita will fight with, this is not the right time to fight here. This is not right. Our Gurudev, these three people, okay, the great acharyas. Then I'll tell you one more slide comes. Bhagavan, our Gurudev, what Gurudev says about the three acharyas, what our Swami Vivekananda says about the three acharyas. Now, these three people are what the great acharyas. They are working in Bandha, Moksha, Jiva, Jagati, Mukti, Sadhana, all the things. Their main theme is the connection between Ishwara and Jiva. Okay, main the connection between Ishwara and Jiva. That's why this vakya is called Mahavakya. What is the subject matter? We are connecting ourselves with the Ishwara. It's not very ordinary relationship. In our life, we make a relationship, we cut relationship. 2 days back, you have friends? Now not. 5 years. Now only understood this fellow. 20 years, I don't understand him. different relationship we have. All the relationships are based on some expectation here. As long as you are very comfortable with me, I am okay with you. You are my, you are my prana. Last year you told you are my prana, today I am telling you are not my prana. What happened? You are not very comfortable. Now only understood you. All relationship. We'll make according to. Now here they are telling that your relationship with the God is eternal, sir. Your relationship with the, him is eternal. We don't understand. Then we read Upanishad, then we understand. Oh, then whatever the relationship we have outside, we are happy. If you come, we are happy. If you go, we are very happy. Why? Time is saved. If you give more people, you have to give more time. If all people are not there, then you are very comfortable. You have ekante sukama setam. Very happy. Getting it? So what is the relationship with Jiva and Ishvara? Now I need to have two people, two more. Two. You don't like this, that's why you are not coming. Come. Yeah. Parola, come. You are a very serious student, that's why they are sitting here. Now, you come this side. And the first person to eat and this, you ought to come now. Now you stand here. Yeah. So you go there. The first person also. You can understand this three philosophy very easily, very simple, okay? No need to spend more time. After this, you can study anything, you can understand very easily. So you have to stand here. You can you do a little bit? All right. You have to do. Right. This is Adi Sankaracharya, okay? The next one is Rama. Next one. Yeah, Ramanuja. Next one is Madhavacharya. Very nice. Now, already 1 hour back I have given, okay? You remember that? Okay. Now you eat it. Don't feel shy. That is yours. You will not get stomach pain also. Don't worry. Right? Little by little. I ate it. Okay. Okay. Give me that. Now, see. He has eaten. Finished. It's gone. Where is the fruit now? Excuse me, where is fruit? Where is the fruit? Where? In the stomach. Yeah, simple answer, but you are good. Where is the fruit? Sir, in the stomach, sir. That's a simple answer. Stomach, okay. So, here's the fruit. Just you show the fruit like this. Okay, here's the fruit there. Okay? Now, you just consider that fruit is Jivatma. Fruit is Jivatma. So, this frame is Paramatma. The whole body is Paramatma. That fruit is Jivatma. Okay? Now, the last that Acharya, Madhvacharya came very recently. He says that, so you have connection with the Brahman. Okay? You have connection with the Brahman, creator. The fruit has got connection with the body or not? Say yes. Fruit will not have connection with this. Okay? There is no connection. Are you getting it? This will not eat fruit. Getting it or not? Are you getting it? There is a connection between fruit and the body. Annamaya. Getting it? Annamaya. The fruit has got deep connection with the body. Therefore, Jiva has got deep connection with this Paramatma. We don't have that much connection with relatives there. All the connections are where you cannot go. You have to go back to your home. Now I understood. You don't have any connection with me. That's all. Now only understood after the banana. I am completely connected with Jeev Paramatma. Then they will tell, don't eat my food, get out. You go and eat from Paramatma, go. The Vyavahara, you should know how to apply it. How to understand the Paramatma, how to live in the Vyavahara also very, very important. Now, the fruit has got deep connection with the body. So, fruit is Jivatma, that body is Paramatma. Madhvacharya says that you are separated from that. Is it okay? You have connection, but you are separate. Then Ramanuja Acharya comes, sir, now where is fruit? Tell me. You getting it? The Jivatma is part of Paramatma. Getting it or not? You are not separated. You are inside this Paramatma. You are the part. You are the Anga. Are you getting it? You are the Anga of this whole Angi. You belong to him. You are the part of the Paramatma. He is there inside. Are you getting it? Take your hands. Ah, it is there. Can you see that? It is there. You're getting it. Ah, this is Bhagavan. Our Ramanuja Acharya came and said, hey, you are not separate. You are the part. So you belong to him. And Adi Sankaracharya comes after 1 hour. Are you getting it? And he says, excuse me, Madhva. Excuse me, Ramanuja. Now you tell me, 1 hour back, I finished it. Or 4 hours back. Now you tell me, where is the banana? Where is the fruit? Now you tell me. Tell me. Digested or not? So you are all reveling in Brahman, I think. Sokda. Where is the banana? Now it has become one with the system. This is called Advaita. You are getting it? Bhagavan Adi Shankara saying, this is Advaita, sir. You are already one with him, okay? So now, there is no need to fight between Advaita, Visishta Advaita, no. Our Gurudev comes, our Swami Vivekananda comes, these people are telling that, don't fight with this. These are all our people only. Adi Shankaracharya belongs to Hinduism. Ramanuja is our person. Madhvacharya is our person. No need to fight. Now, you have to start your spiritual journey with Madhva, and you have to develop with Ramanuja, and you have to attain Adi Shankaracharya. We are getting it. This is what our Gurudev says, Swami Vivekananda says. You understood? Now you understood 3 philosophies in 5 minutes. Finished. Thank you very much. You can have that. You understood? All the 3 people have written commentary for Bhrahma Sutra, Upanishad, Bhagavad Gita. There are different for that interpretation needed according to that generation. You getting it? Every Acharya knows that. So when Brahmanuja Acharya writes commentary on that, he understood Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya and he brought his philosophy according to the time of the people. Getting it? When Madhvacharya writes this, he needs to present all the avatara purushas only. They understood and they brought this kind of interpretation according to that the mindset of the people. So our Gurudev came and you understood this? Because I cannot give the banana here. If I give apple, it will take more time. That's why I gave banana, okay? Are you getting it? You see the banana, this Dvaita, are you getting it? Holding the Jivatma is separated from Paramatma. Your Jivatma is inside. That's why this fellow is looking bulky. He has eaten bulky, okay? These persons digested. They were very happy. You getting it? Yeah, very happy. All the 3 acharyas, there is no contradiction. According to that mental setup of the people, they have to give this kind of interpretation. They understood everything. There is no fight. There is the harmony among these 3 acharyas. Our Swami Vivekananda and our Gurudev. It's true, great, what is that? The lions of Hinduism. These 2 people only brought out this modern thoughts for Hinduism. It's not we should not keep our ideas only in the book. They only brought to our place where we are working. Great missionaries, great visionaries. Once our Hanuman, our Rama asked Hanuman, hey Hanuman, you tell me how you consider me. Very, very popular sloka. Don't hear the bell, okay? Bell is ringing. I know you are not hearing it. Say yes. Very good. Deha buddhya dasoham jiva buddhya todamsakha atma buddhya tvamevaham iti me nishita mati. According to my, what is that? From the standpoint of body, I am your dasa. From standpoint of jiva, I am your amsha. From the standpoint of atma, yeah. This is very, very relevant to this context, okay? You understood. Why you have to understand, there is no other go. Simple. The theme of the Vedas, okay? The theme of the Vedas, karma, upasana. Here jnana, okay? This is called dharma, this is called brahma. So karma upasana explains about dharma, jnana kanda explains about brahma, paramat brahma. So theme of Vedas, dharma and brahma, which is unknown. You cannot see that. Only through Veda only we can understand whether it is existing or not. So this is discussed more in Upanishad, in the 4 sutras also. Now, this Vedas, this karma and upasana is called abhyudaya. Jnanakanda is called Nishrayasa. Abhyudaya explains about Dharma Artha Kama. Nishrayasa explains about Moksha. The Dharma Artha Kama is called goal in life. Moksha is called goal of life. Getting it?
So Hinduism is complete that. It will not show you only the liberation. You get the liberation through dharma artha kama. Follow your dharma, get your wealth and enjoy whatever you want according to, you see, you have to draw your what you call the compound. Within the compound, you can enjoy whatever you want. This is called dharma. You draw the dharma. In that dharma, you bring your artha and you enjoy your kama. After that, you have to spit out like, spit out. Like when we take the chewing gum, what is that, bubble gum. And Gurudev used to say, how long you will have bubble gum? As long as I have the sweetness and the peppermint smell. After that, you have to thukritye. Bhagavan Adi Sankaracharya writes his commentary in Sanskrit. In one of the Upanishads or Bhrahma Sutra, I don't remember, but in his commentary only he says, Bhagavan Adi Sankaracharya, after enjoying this world, you have to thukritye. Sanskrit. He says a thukritye is Sanskrit word. Thukritye. So you have to spit it out. After that only you have to come to Upanishad class and you have to read and you have to get moksha. When you come to Upanishad class, then you have the goal of life. Then you live in the family, goal in life. I know you got it. This hammer throw and this way, hammer throw is one of the games. Okay, hammer throw means you take the hammer and you have to rotate. So around you there will be the net. Because otherwise, if you throw this to someone. You have to get the acceleration. When you take this hammer, you have to get the acceleration. When you get very nice acceleration, you have to release it. Getting it? Well, then why you are telling this to me? Come. You see this over that thing? Taking the hammer and rotating, okay? When you rotate, this is called goal in life. Dharma artha kama, okay? You keep on rotating this, not the goal. You have to release it. That is the goal. Getting it or not, when you release this girl, goal of life. To release from my hand only, I started rotating it. You getting it? You keep on rotating. Suppose you go inside this net and keep on rotating. People are, when are you going to release? No, I'm very happy. I feel happy when I rotate. When are you going to release? No idea. Suppose you die. I die. I rotated, I die, I kept my hammer here cell. I will come back. I will take another janma, I will say, where is my hammer? Again, I will rotate. In many janmas, I kept on rotating. When are you going to release? No, I feel very happy when I rotate. Sometimes, along with the, I will also rotate with this. Sir, rotating the hammer is not goal of life, that is goal in life. Get acceleration. For what? You have to release it. When a release is called goal of life. To release only, we have to rotate it. You getting it? To get moksha only, dharma artha kama kept. Moksha is the final goal. To go to final goal. So when you product the car, the car productions of the body is ready, the electronic system is ready, they kept all the wheel, engine, everything, they were that fixed for what? To get released. You have to dispatch. It has to serve the road. Getting it? You just assemble everything and keep everything inside the company. In 1 week, you close the company, finished. The purpose of whole creation is you have to dispatch it. You getting it? So the theme of Vedas is what that? Goal in life and goal of life. So dharma artha kama is a very common idea of Sanatana Dharma. No other religion will explain this kind of concept. So we have seen all the dharma, the kama, goal in life. We are sitting here to get goal of life. Okay? Goal of life will get only through this Upanishad, Jnana Kanda. This Upanishad is nothing but what the essence of all the Vedas. Upanishad we can study or Bhrahma Sutra or what that? Bhagavad Gita. We cannot think this what the Bhagavad Gita is. Are you going to Bhagavad Gita? Bhagavad Gita. What chapter told you? I have bhakti. Go. Where are you going in Upanishad? It's okay. Better. What you are studying? Brahma Sutra. Studying Brahma Sutra means not very high. Studying Upanishad means it's okay. Studying Gita, it's okay. Common man, go.
பஜகோவிந்தமா? ஐயோ, அப்ரண்டிஷிப் என்ட்ரன்ஸா? என்ட்ரன்ஸ். ஆல் திஸ் மேட் ஃபார் அக்கார்டிங் டு அதிகாரி பேத். அக்கார்டிங் டு அதிகாரி சீதே உபனிஷத் லைக் ஜாகிரி. ஜாகிரி வெல்லம். உபனிஷத் இஸ் லைக் வெல்லம் ஜாகிரி. யூ கேனாட் ஈட் இட் மோர், வெரி லிட்டில் ஓன்லி யூ கேன் ஈட். உபனிஷத் ஒரிஜினல் ஜாகிரி. ஃப்ரம் தட் ஜாகிரி யூ மேக் வாட் த பாயசம். ஓகே, யூ மேக் பாயசம். திஸ் பாயசம் இஸ் கால்டு பகவத்கீதா. சைல்டு ஆல்சோ கேன் ஈட் இட் அண்ட் ஸ்காலர் ஆல்சோ கேன் ஈட் இட். ஓகே, த ஓல்டு பீப்புள் ஆல்சோ கேன். ஓல்டு மீன்ஸ் வாட்? த சேம் சைல்டு இஷு. திஸ் நோ டீத் இன்ஸ். சைல்டு ஆல்சோ கேன் ட்ரிங்க், 90 இயர் ஆல்சோ கேன் ட்ரிங்க் அண்ட் 20-25 இயர் ஆல்சோ கேன். பாயசம் மென் ஃபார் ஆல். ஓகே, த பாயசம் இஸ் மேட் அப் ஆஃப் வாட்? ஜாக்கரி. ஜாக்கரி அதர் ப்ரெசன்டேஷன். So I don't like this payasam with a spoon. Hey, what is my status? Hey, no, I am 25 years old. I want to bite something. Then you make the same jaggery candy, hard candy. Okay, what do you call kamar kattu? Very hard candy. I give it. Kattak.
He thought that he broke this candy, but candy broke.
What is that candy? This is also made up of, getting it? Same Bhagavan Vedavyasa made this tree. Bhagavan Vedavyasa compiled this jaggery like Upanishad. He only compiled. He only made payasam for us. He only made jaggery. No, you came here to eat
candy. Your karma worked differently. Now you are having original jaggery.
That's it. Getting it? Getting it or not? Yes, sir. That's what happened here. But the essence is same. Getting it? The same Bhagavan Vedavyasa. He knows how to make things. Oh, if you are 25 years old, you take this. Then after that, one day you will come to payasam. Because you are 25, that's why you are asking for the candy. 2-3 candy. Appa, enough. Can you give me some jaggery? Come. Give me some payasam. Come da. Come there. You come there. So the presentation is different, but the essence is same. You getting it? Oh. We should not say when we study Brahma Sutra, Purana, ayyo. Still you are in Purana, ma. So Bhagavan Vedavyasa is a powerful scholar. He can make Brahma Sutra for scholars. The same person brought the Brahma Sutra idea in over that Balavihar class, Purana Hidigasa. You getting it? Same person, same author. He knew how to bring this idea to the common, very, very common man. And the same idea, he knows how to write for scholars. Powerful teacher, Bhagavan Vedavyas. From this range to that range. Very good. Oh, great Acharya. It is very amazing to watch his work. Okay? Thank you very much. Because you already study Upanishad, already you study everything. Adhyasa Bhashya and first sutra and all. No need to bring and break your head. I don't want to break your head. Already you are in. Already soaked. Soaked and you have become very sweet. That's why when I ask something, you are not answering. Why? Enjoying the sweetness. Keep coming. Next year you come. By then you will get ready. Because your karma works like that. What to do then? This time? So you expected. Anyway, everything happens for good only. Okay, this is a very nice place. Keep coming. Bhagavan, by Adi Sankaracharya's grace, we will get the Advaita Siddhi. Ishwara Anugraha Deva Pumsam Advaita Vasana. Advaita Vasana will not get very easily. Special grace we should have. Then only we will get the Advaita. Aham Brahmasmi, the thought itself is very powerful. Almost we are for the near the liberation. When you say Aham Brahmasmi, near the liberation, that's all. Almost you have come. You are not ordinary. Everybody should worship you. You are telling, but my family members. You are telling too much, sir. When I go back, and they say, have you come back? You told 10 days, in 5 days you have come. It's not for others to worship us. We have to understand our glory.
our greatness. Pura Janma Karma only we got grace. Lots of extraordinary grace. Okay? Bhagavan Adi Sankaracharya bless you, our Gurudev bless you. May you attain the great goal of life, Brahmastiti. Okay? Thank you very much. Hari Om. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Avasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.